You can feel the tension in the air as we move into race day here at Monaco. It's a track that requires the full concentration of the drivers with zero margin for error. It tests their skills to the absolute limits. So no wonder it remains a fan favorite. The prestigious Circuit de Monaco then, it's not all that dissimilar today to the layout that made its debut almost a century ago. It's 2 miles and 19 corners through the streets of Monte Carlo, and although the average lap speed of around 93 miles per hour is the lowest of the season, the tiny margins for error make it the natural habitat of the safety car. And as always, a man with plenty of racing experience joins me in the commentary box. Today, it's Anthony Davidson. Tell me, Ant, you're no stranger to surviving the melee of Turn 1. So how do you keep out of trouble when there's so much going on around you?
There are three main things to worry about there, Crofty. Positioning, awareness, and discipline. First, you have to put your car in a bit of space and make sure you have room to react to what the others are doing. Then you have to watch your mirrors and listen to the sounds around you to get a sense of where everyone is. And finally, just don't get too greedy. Just because a gap exists doesn't always mean you should go for it.
Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. An immense lap from Carlos Sainz yesterday puts him in pole position, and Lewis Hamilton completes the front row. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Bottas, Sergio Perez, and Norris, Leclerc, Fernando Alonso, Ricciardo, and Pierre Gasly, Ocon, Tsunoda, Sebastian Vettel, and Stroll, Raikkonen, Giovinazzi, George Russell, and Mick Schumacher, Latifi, and Nikita Mazepin. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track.
Okay, here we go. I know what you can do. Don't let me down.
Okay, DRS is now available.
That move was reckless. We're lucky not to have been penalised.
There's been an incident on track resulting in loose debris. Fortunately, the marshals have managed to clear it up in time and there are no plans for a safety car right now.
We're approaching the pit window. You'll be on the mediums. Good job. That was the fastest lap of the race so far. We're boxing this lap. Give us the best in lap you can. Complete. Go now. That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. Charles is in for his stop. Gap to car in front is 2.2 seconds. Great work. That's a new fastest lap of the race. Okay, you're catching the car ahead, but remember, we need to get to the end of the race on these tyres.
We're leading our teammate by 10.4 seconds.
DRS will be offline. There's a fault with the rear wing system. Stay out. We can work on a fix remotely. That was the fastest lap of the race. Keep this up. Okay, good work, great pass.
gap to teammate behind is 25.3 seconds. You're losing 2 seconds a lap to the car behind. 2 seconds. There's 5 laps of fuel remaining. Thank you. Okay, the gap behind is 2.6 seconds. There's three laps of fuel remaining. This is your final lap. Final lap of the race, we're leading our teammate by 28.1 seconds. Fantastic! You've won the Grand Prix!
That's it then for another nail-biting Monaco Grand Prix. We were on the edge of our seats the whole time, but they've come through to take a stunning victory. Tell me, Ant, how do you think they were able to deliver such an incredible result today?
Well, I honestly feel it was down to the driver and car today. I mean, we can talk driver skill all day, but if you don't have a solid team to back that, you're never going to get anywhere. When you hit that sweet spot of having both an excellent driver and an incredible car, that's when you see results like those we witnessed today.
Here come our winners now. A thrilling race and a tremendous effort by Ferrari. Their history is well known, so it's no surprise to fans the world over to see them come out on top once again. And with his performance today, Carlos Sainz assumes the top spot in the championship.